few weeks ago, I introduced in my video Real Ultimate Hackintosh Build for year 2019, Real 14-core iMac Pro Killer. That build had huge success, and I did some further updates to it, and in this video, you will find additional useful information and tips how to increase already great performance. Hi, I'm Teresa from Morganite.cloud, and I help people with Hackintosh builds, Macintosh computers, Linux servers, simply with computers. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. Last week I posted updated Geekbench scores of my brand new another Hackintosh build based on the same components, which were really impressive, and a lot of people asked me how to achieve that, and I will tell you in this video how to get the same results. So let's have a look at it. As you can see, I'm running the Intel Core i9-9900K paired with great memory. I recommend the HyperX running at stock 3600 MHz. Important note, this build is not overclocked. Again, yes, no overclock. This build is running at stock settings, stock voltages, stock everything. So, let's run the benchmark and see yourself what a great results I can get from it. ...6,862 single-core performance and 40,238 multi-core score. Just for fun, let's compare these scores with other Intel CPUs. So my single-core performance is on top of the chart, and my multi-core score is right between two 14-core CPUs, the i9-7940X and the i9-9940X, which costs quite three times more than my i9-9900K. So, how can you also get the same performance? First, you need of course the Intel Core i9-9900K, and by my opinion, best motherboard for Hackintosh, the Gigabyte Z390 with native Thunderbolt 3 on board, and the memory I use, or better. By the way, links to all of that you can find now in my video description, if you still don't have it. This i9 CPUs currently on the market have two revisions, P0 and R0. P0 works on this motherboard from BIOS version F3, but the newer one have the support in BIOS from version F6. So if you already have the new CPU and you plan to buy this motherboard, make sure it has already the newest BIOS or ask your seller to update it. I recommended in the past to everybody to stay at the F5 BIOS version, which worked the best. But with the new CPU revision, I had to test again the latest F6 BIOS. Newest current version is F6N, which you can find also in this video description. Previous versions did not allow you to easily use the full potential of this 3300 MHz memory. Now you can! So, you need the CPU, this motherboard and this memory. What else? You need my already prepared and tweaked EFI folder for this build with Vega GPU. I use the latest macOS version, which is at the date of shooting of this video, the macOS Mojave 10.14.5. And the last step, but mandatory and very important, is correct BIOS settings. A lot of people still think tweaked EFI is all they need. No, you need also to set correctly your BIOS. And as I always say, I cannot make it easier for people. In this video description, you can find also prepared BIOS preset for the F6N BIOS version with all necessary settings pre-filled. So all you have to do is just to load this profile in your BIOS, save the BIOS and reboot. That's all. So on this hardware, you can easily achieve those amazing results too, without any overclocking, which I don't recommend by the way. It's not worth the much higher power consumption, a lot more heat, need for better cooling system and shorten lifespan of your components. Just update your BIOS to version F6N, download my tweaked EFI and the BIOS preset, which is all free for my supporters, and enjoy your increased performance of your ultimate Hackintosh build. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button so more people can benefit from it. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. You can also reach me at my Facebook, Twitter, Reddit or my website. Links are again now in this video description. Morgonaut is always here to help. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Hackintosh friends.